Once again, good evening. I'm William Cooper, and you're listening to the Hour of the Time. Well, first off, folks, I want to finally figure out what's going on with this Forever Free America rally that was scheduled for March the 11th, 1995. It appears they wanted some money and some free advertising. So I'm going to tell you that little story, and then I'm going to tell you about a Constitution Party meeting in Pennsylvania. And then we're going to get into the broadcast, and we're going to take calls tonight. A lot of people got their issue of Veritas today, and we want you to call in and tell us what you think. We've worked hard, and we'd like to hear your comments and criticisms, and if anybody out there is an expert at newspaper production, we'd like to hear your constructive criticism on how we might be able to make it a better newspaper. Because we've never done this before, folks, and what you see is the product of a whole bunch of amateurs running around all day and all night, bleary-eyed the next day, trying to get the thing out. And we've been working on the second issue ever since the first one came off the presses. So this is liable to kill us, but we're going to do it anyway. The Forever Free America rally was scheduled for March 11, 1995. Michael Silverhawk called and wanted me to speak. And I said yes, I would speak after checking my schedule. And then I got a call that was very strange, folks. He wanted to know how many people I thought would show up to buy advance tickets. And I told him, well, if he was counting on advance ticket sales, to forget it. And it was like I hit him in the stomach. I mean, he was just like crushed. And then that's when he confided in me that he was counting on the advance ticket sales in order to pay for the place where they were going to have this thing. And I told him if he was counting on that, it probably wasn't going to happen. So he asked me for Aaron Russo's number, and I gave him Aaron Russo's number. I didn't know what he was going to call him for, but he called Aaron Russo, and I found out that he wanted Aaron Russo to give him a whole bunch of thousands of dollars in order to fund this Forever Free America rally. In the meantime, we were getting faxes saying that it had been changed from March 11th to April the 22nd, and that was the week where we had planned to schedule a seminar here, and we're in the process of notifying people and lining up speakers, and when we got this thing that it was rescheduled April 22nd, then we had to cancel that. And also, a lot of people began showing up here on their way to California. And they were extremely disappointed because they had taken time off, and some of them had planned vacations to go to California to attend this thing on March 11th. So a lot of people are very upset about this. A lot of people who planned on attending a rally here, a seminar here, the week of April 22nd, are very upset. I'm very upset because just a few days ago, Michael Silverhawk called me and said after all the free advertising we've given him, after canceling our seminar during the week of April 22nd, and because I had already committed to speak at his thing and was trying to help him out, after trying to coerce money out of Aaron Russo from the Constitution Party to finance this thing, he called me up and said, Bill, you're not speaking, nothing personal. So I just wanted to let you know what's going on with these people. This is really flaky, folks. And I'm not telling you not to go. I'm telling you that it's really flaky and that they've really screwed over a lot of people, and you're going to have to make up your own minds. But I figured you better know that. I will not be speaking, not because I canceled, but because Michael Silverhawk arbitrarily called up after we'd give him all this free radio time, and after he had tried to get money out of the Constitution Party to finance the thing. Maybe he did it out of spite because Aaron said no. You can't divert party funds to sponsor something that has nothing to do with the Constitution Party. So anyway, he canceled me as a speaker. I will not be there. But for those of you who want to go, there are some other good speakers who are scheduled to be there. Whether they're going to be there or not actually, I have no idea. Because if they got the flaky treatment that we got and that a lot of other people got, it's questionable whether anybody's going to be there, to tell you the truth. So that's just for your information. The Constitution Party of Pennsylvania, the Delaware Valley Chapter, will hold their regular meeting on Thursday, March the 23rd. Thursday, March 23rd. The Delaware Valley Chapter of the Constitution Party of Pennsylvania, Thursday, March 23rd at 7:30 p.m. That's 7:30 p.m. It'll be held at the Villanova Family Diner. The Villanova Family Diner, that's routes 30 and 320, 1,000 feet east of Interstate 476. I can just see 300 people out there measuring off 1,000 feet. They probably got a big sign, as most diners do. The Villanova Family Diner, routes 30 and 320, 1,000 feet east of Interstate 476. That's routes 30 and 320, 1,000 feet east of Interstate 476 in Villanova, Pennsylvania. That's a suburb, ladies and gentlemen, of Philadelphia, according to this fax that I have here. And it's for people from the Delaware Valley area of Pennsylvania, Lehigh Valley area of Pennsylvania, and southern New Jersey and northern Delaware states. For information, call Jackie at 610-896-8897. That's Jackie at 610-896-8897. One more time. Jackie at 610-896-8897. That's between 10 a.m. and 5 p.m. That's for daytime callers. Or you can call Mike at 610-494-2113. That's Mike at 610-494-2113. Between 7 p.m. and 10 p.m. That's for evening callers. Okay? That's Mike at 610-494-2113. Once again, it's the Constitution Party of Pennsylvania, Delaware Valley Chapter. We'll hold a regular meeting on Thursday, March 23rd, 1995 at 7:30 p.m. at the Villanova Family Diner, routes 30 and 320, 1,000 feet east of Interstate 476, Villanova, Pennsylvania. That's a suburb of Philadelphia. That's for people from the Delaware Valley area of Pennsylvania, Lehigh Valley area, and southern New Jersey and northern Delaware states. Don't go away, folks. If you received your copy of Veritas today, we want to hear from you. Tonight, we want to hear your comments, what you think about the newspaper, any constructive criticisms that you may have. If you have questions about submitting articles or whatever, I'm here to answer those questions, and let's hear from everybody. The number, for those of you who have never called or never wrote down the number, is 602-337-2524. That's 602-337-2524. We've been working hard on that paper, and we're working hard on the next one.
You know that the sound of the men working on the chain. Yeah, that the sound of the men working on the chain. Yeah, on the train. sound of the men working on the chain. Yeah, that the sound of the men working on the chain. Yeah,
on they work so hard till the sun is going down. Working on the highways and byways and wearing a crown.
Well, I've got my copy in front of me, folks, and we've been getting calls all day about this paper. And I'd like for some of you out there to hear some of the comments, good or bad, whatever they are. And let's go right to the phones. Good evening, you're on the air.
Hi, this is Mike from Pennsylvania.
Hello, Mike, how are you?
And that's an excellent piece of journalism. It is probably, in fact, no doubt, it is the finest newspaper in the Patriot community that I have ever read.
Wow.
And I certainly would love to see more and more and more of it.
Well, being as that was our first effort, and we learned an awful lot, I think each issue will be better than the last. Because, you know, we're in a learning curve, and we were a little surprised at what we were able to do, but... when we look back at the amount of work we put in, it really wasn't so surprising after all. But what did you like most about it?
What I liked is the information, that it was bold, it was accurate, it was very well presented. It wasn't meant to cause any radical reaction. I think it was most informative, and I think something like that should sell well on college campuses, and I urge anyone who has any contact with a college to make sure that paper is sold, or to start a constitutional club at a college. That's something we're terribly lacking.
Well, I sure thank you for your comments. And what do you think about the blue color on the front page?
I think that's a good balance. It makes a bit of a contrast instead of a totally black paper. I think it's good. It's probably expensive, but I hope it doesn't interfere with any news content or any extra amount of pages.
No, it is expensive, but I don't like to do things halfway. It's got to be good, or I just can't put my name on it. That's just the way I am, or at least the way I want to be. Not everything turns out that way, but we certainly do try. Thank you so much.
Sure thing, Bill.
Good night.
Right.
And, I got a good point. For any of you out there thinking about becoming a distributor for Veritas, it's very attractive. All you need to do is call and talk to Bart. Anytime during the day between 9 a.m. and 6 p.m., except on Monday and Tuesdays when we're closed. So if you're interested in being a distributor for the newspaper, call Bart. He'll tell you all about it. Also, we have an excellent referral program. And subscription referral program, and that's for people who have already subscribed. You have to be a current subscriber, and if you are, then you can sell subscriptions. And our plan is much more attractive than any other, because every time you sell a subscription to Veritas, you keep $10, and you send us $40. And all you have to do is send your name and address along with the persons or people, the list of names and addresses that you've sold subscriptions to, along with the correct amount of money, and you pocket the $10, and we go from there. So now, if you're interested in doing that, make sure that you have the letter that we send you verifying your subscription, and that you're... that explains the subscription referral program, because you should show that to subscribers to make sure that they know that you're legitimate. Good evening. You're on the air. Good evening. Hello. You're on the air.
Yes.
Yes.
My name is Michael. I'm from South Jersey.
Hello, Michael.
Just got your first paper here in front of me, and I wanted to tell you that I think it's a marvelous piece of journalism. You're a very bright man. When I first heard your... original broadcast, when I first started tuning into you, I got a little bit concerned because some of the things I heard were kind of scary. And when I got this paper today, I read the open letter that you read.
Uh-huh.
And believe me, I just changed completely my whole attitude about you, who you are, by reading your history as a patriot.
Mm-hmm.
And the things you had witnessed. while you were in the service. I'm down here in South Jersey, and it's also, I just got the message about the Constitution Party that's going to be meeting over there in Pennsylvania.
Yes.
I'm going to try to get out there, Phil.
Wonderful.
I had a couple of things I wanted to talk to you about. First of all, you're getting race baited.
I'm getting what?
You're being race baited, as I'm sure you know. You mentioned that in your paper about race baiting.
Oh, yeah. That happens to all patriots who are effective against our common enemy. The first thing they do is label you a racist, anti-Semite, and all that kind of stuff. I have a better a chance at survival of that than most people, because whenever I'm at some place speaking and somebody starts that stuff, I just turn around and ask my wife to stand up, and that kills it right there. She's Chinese, and it's...
I have a couple of questions. There was something I didn't understand really quick. You're doing an article, you're doing like the history of these... conspiracies that are attempting to strip the sovereignty away from the...
Not conspiracy.
It's from the horse's mouth. I got it right here. It's out in the open.
Right.
The Illuminati, the way you explain it, it's a combination of all these other groups that you have in there?
No, it's not a combination of those groups. You see, most people who belong to those groups don't know anything about what they really belong to. They really don't know what's going on. But they are slowly being indoctrinated into accepting the theology of the New World Order and the politics and the political correct thinking that goes along with it. The adepts at the highest levels of all of the so-called fraternal secret orders and secret societies, some not so fraternal, constitute the collective body known as the Illuminati. Illuminati is simply plural for illuminate, are the illumined, and it is the total combined number of adepts at the highest degrees of all of the secret societies that consider themselves to be illumined. That is the Illuminati. They have a common goal. They follow a common plan. They have a common religion. They collectively hate the traditional fundamentalist religions of the world, Christianity, Judaism, and the Islamic religion. They want the elimination of all sovereign nation states. They want one world government controlled by them.
Fascinating. I noticed on the first page from the horse's mouth in 1776 at the very top, the first name you mentioned is Adam Weishaupt, and in my research through of this, which I've only been doing about a year or so, and I'm glad I found your station, Adam Weishaupt was one of the men that brought Freemasonry here, if I recall. Am I correct?
Well, he didn't bring it here, and Freemasonry existed before Adam Weishaupt came along, and so did the Illuminati. All he did was create a particular branch in Bavaria whose politics and policy was extremely activist, much more so than it had been in the past under the other lodge auspices. He got caught. And when he got caught by the Bavarian government, they made all the plans and all the writings that they had discovered in the Bavarian lodge available to the other lodges, to the other monarchies in the other countries. And so Weishaupt's branch of what he called the Illuminati was destroyed, supposedly. But he had already sent out many of his members to penetrate and infiltrate other lodges and spread his doctrine in that manner. In the United States, it surfaced in not only Freemasonry, but in the most active branch of the Illuminati in the United States was known as the Jacobins. And later there was another one called the Oddfellows. And most of those have sort of faded into the background or disappeared altogether, and the most powerful group and the one that really controls most of the politics in the United States aimed toward one world government is the Scottish Rite and the York Rite of Freemasonry.
So I'm going to be looking forward to joining your Constitution Party.
Wonderful.
I have one more thing I wanted to mention, the P2 Lodge. How is that interconnected with all this?
Well, the P2 Lodge was actually formed by the adepts of the American intelligence community in conjunction with the adepts in Europe and some of the higher-ups of the Vatican, and it literally furnished as a connection with the underworld in Europe and an organization that furnished information to the American intelligence community from its members.
Unbelievable. I'm a labor activist down here in South Jersey, and I've come across and I've tried to expound some of my politics about what I've discovered about some of this stuff, and of course, I've been baited everything from a lunatic to a racist to et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And I wanted just to let you know that I look forward to getting another one of your publications. I think it's wonderful. When I first got it, I saw the Veritas. So, I guess that's Latin, isn't it?
Veritas, yes.
Veritas on the top. And I thought it was a mistake because I saw these foreign words on there. Opened it up and I saw Bill Cooper. And I said, this is the guy I found on the shortwave station.
Yeah.
And I'm really glad that you sent out this paper to me. I had communicated to you about this. And I'm very thankful and glad that I got this from you. And I will certainly be subscribing and looking forward to becoming part of your Constitution Party.
Great. Thank you for calling.
Thank you.
A lot of you folks got issues free gratis, the first issue, and you won't get another one if you're not a subscriber. The first one is just to give you a look and a taste, and there's a subscription form on the back page. And if you want to continue to get it, you're going to have to subscribe because we're not going to send free copies out to the same people in the second issue. We'll always sprinkle some free copies to non-subscribers, but never the same people twice. Good evening. You're on the air.
Old man Cooper, that old man Cooper, he must know something, but he say nothing. That old man Cooper, that old man Cooper, he just go babbling along.
It is high, it is far, it is gone.
Well, folks, that is one who chooses to make a complete ass out of himself in front of the whole world. One of the little poopy diaper kids that got lost from his mommy at the grocery store. You know, I don't mind if you want to criticize or whatever you want to say. In fact, I'll let you do it. If you want to make an ass out of yourself, I'll let you do it right in front of the world. It's a shame that you don't have the balls, though, to stay on and tell us who you are or argue your points constructively. And usually when you don't do that, it's because you can't. And that's a fact. The number, for those of you who never wrote it down or don't have it, is 602-337-2524. Let's, you know, it's okay tonight if any more of you crazies want to call and display your dirty diapers to us, that's okay, because the more you do that, the more we know that we're right on the money about you. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill.
Hello.
Arch from Fort Lauderdale.
Hello.
Yes. Bill, thank you so much for sending me Veritas.
Oh, you're welcome.
I was so surprised. I opened the paper, and here is the antithesis of masonry staring me in the face with the all-seeing eye of the naked truth just blaring out at me. I was shocked, and I can see now what it means. It's the mother goddess of truth that is being fertilized by this paper and giving birth to the Omnia Vincit Veritas, which is the truth conquers all.
Well, that's pretty good. Pretty good translation there.
Excellent. And when they see it, when they see this, unless they are completely blind, they'll realize what they're up against. And
well, you know, this goes to everybody in Washington, D.C. And I mean everybody. They're the only people who get free copies. President, Vice President, all the members of the Cabinet, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, the members of the Supreme Court, every single representative and every senator gets a free copy of Veritas every issue.
Well, I think that if there is such a thing as the hierarchy, I think this so-called externalization is going to be put back under the rock from which it came. soon, as soon as they are given, I believe it's true, the taste of the truth will prevail. And I want to thank you for this newspaper, Bill. God bless you, and I hope we will overcome through the Constitution Party and bring this nation back from the brink of hell.
Thank you.
God bless you. Bye-bye.
And thank you for calling. Number 602-337-2524. And, you know, the one of the previous callers was talking about the very first date that we had was 1776, and the quote from Adam Weir. I thought, what we have in this issue, folks, is five full pages, full newspaper pages, year by year, from their own mouths, convicting themselves and showing you and giving you the exact source of the quotes so that you can follow it year by year, how we've come to be exactly where we're at. It will blow you away. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yes, good evening. First of all, are Springer Wishers at Brass House available?
Yes, they are. It's $3 plus postage, whatever it is. Much cheaper to subscribe, I'll tell you that.
Okay. I was wondering if you could discuss, I heard you talk about the Knights of Malta. A little bit, and I was wondering if you could elaborate somewhat on their role in working with masonry and so on. Did you see it?
Well, the Knights of Malta originally were called the Knights Hospitallers, or the Hospitallers of St. John of Jerusalem, and when the Templars fell, the king and the Pope, the King of France and the Pope, turned the property that they didn't want to split between themselves over to the Hospitallers, who basically ran hospitals and things like that, created hospitals and hospices and places for dying people to go. And they turned the property over to them. The Knights Templars, of course, swore revenge. And it was unbelievable, the revenge that they wreaked. In fact, when the French Revolution occurred, it was brought about actually by the remnant of the Knights Templars who had infiltrated the lodges and became a part of the adepts of the Illuminati. Their first revenge was wreaked upon the Hospitallers of St. John of Jerusalem, and they actually took back over, and the Knights of Malta now are actually the old Knights Templars reinstated.
Are they actively working with masonry, as you said? I mean, weren't people like
Kim? The highest adepts of all of these secret societies work together.
Mm-hmm.
They appear to be opposed to each other in some instances to the public, but they're not at all at the highest levels.
Weren't people like Bill Casey involved with the Knights of Malta?
William Casey was Knights of Malta. the name is slipping my tongue.
Peter Lynch, I think, isn't he? Anyone with the Fidelity?
Yes. Also, George Bush just made a tour of Central America and Mexico speaking in behalf of the Knights of Malta. He belongs to the Skull of Bones of the Russell Trust, which is the symbol, actually, that you'll find on the graves of the Knights Templars is the skull and bones.
Do you see this? I heard you say in your program that you see this as a socialist conspiracy. I mean, do you really think they're socialists in the sense that we've come to know that term, or do you really think they want, from your perspective, a world where a handful of huge international banks and so on and so forth basically... treat everybody else like peons, working for 10 cents an hour.
Socialism is the best way to control a population that there is.
But you see these people working to enrich themselves. I mean, they're not...
Well, listen to what I said.
Yeah.
Socialism is the best way to control a population that there is.
Mm-hmm. To the end of enriching themselves, though. I'm not the traditional socialist ideal as it's been, put forward.
It never is. The goal is power and control. The common man perceives it as good for the common man. He never knows what goes on at the top. The common man is lied to from the time he's born till the time he dies. And generally, if you want to get along in society, you believe the lie and you don't make waves.
Well, I have to tell you this. You've gotten me interested in the subjects, particularly about masonry, and I've, you know, and these secret societies, and I've done a lot of work, done a lot of research in the last couple of years or so, listening based on the shortwave, and I have to admit, I associated like things with masonry with the Shriners hospitals, and you know, I had a very superficial knowledge about this stuff.
Yeah, and that's why they have those things, is so the public will perceive them as being good for the community. The truth is that all the money that they take in, only 3% goes toward those hospitals and toward children and toward the community. The rest of it goes in their pockets.
Well, I have to say this, you know, they don't agree with that everything. What I checked out regarding these groups that you've mentioned and some of these other shortwave shows have mentioned has checked out. So it certainly, you know, increased my knowledge about this quite a bit. I thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you for calling.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
The newspaper will help you with that because the newspaper cites all its sources. It's the only newspaper in the world where you will find that not only we say something, but we back it up and cite the source, and you can go find that source and find exactly the same thing, and you can prove it to your neighbors. I mean, this is really going to help all of you an awful lot. Don't go away. I'll be right back.
If I go a million miles away, I'd write a letter each and every day. For honey, nothing can ever change the love I have for you. And you can pass me by, but honey, nothing can ever change this love I have for you.
That's dedicated to everybody who's ever helped me in my cause, and I sincerely mean it. Nothing can ever change my love for those who have dedicated their lives and who have taken risks and put themselves in awkward situations in order to help me at various points in my life and with this work. I want to sincerely thank you all, and I want to thank Craig Smith from the bottom of my heart and Swiss America Trading. Without their help, without their sponsorship of this broadcast, without allowing us to reach the position that we have reached, Veritas would never have come into being. There would be no newspaper. And I want to thank also the young people, the young men and women who came from California and left their homes and their jobs. Some of them were good, really good paying jobs and really secure situations to take a risk with me and make this dream come true. Bart and Mike and Sharon, I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I love you. You've worked so hard, and what you're hearing tonight from these people is due, for the most part, because of your honest work. You'll also see, folks, if you've received Veritas, that there's about a little over a three-quarter page ad in there thanking Craig Smith and Swiss America Trading. And I would like for you to call them and thank them also. You don't have to buy anything, but they'd like to know that that their efforts have meant something to not only me, but to you, too. So call Swiss America Trading and thank them for all that they've done to help make Veritas a reality. And while you're at it, you might as well ask them how you can devote some of your assets to the accumulation of at least some real money. I know a lot of you think that you can't afford it, but that's not true, and Swiss America Trading will bend over backwards to help you. So call 1-800-289-2646. Do it now. You know how we all tend to be. We tend to procrastinate. Once again, I thank everybody from the bottom of my heart who's ever done anything or gone out on a limb to help me or our cause, and who have really been the ones who have made this all possible. Thank you very much. Good evening, you're on the air.
Yes, sir. Thank you. My name's Tim. I'm calling from Virginia. And I'd never heard about your Veritas newspaper before, and I was wondering how could I hadn't heard of it before get a copy of it.
You can call on Wednesday and find out how much the postage is, because I don't know. Okay. But you need, if you want one copy, send $3 plus whatever the postage is. And you better hurry, because the first issue is almost all gone. We only printed 2,000 copies, and they're almost out the door. If you want to subscribe, it's $50 for 24 issues if you live in the United States. If you live in Canada or any other country, it's $70 U.S. funds for 24 issues.
Okay, well, I appreciate what you're doing here, sir, and keep up the good work, and I'll be calling Wednesday.
Thank you very much.
Thank you much.
And good night. 602-337-2524. If you've received your copy of Veritas, please call in and let us know what you think. If you have some criticism and you'd like to tell us how you think we can make it better, please do so. Please feel free. Good evening. You're on the air.
Good evening, William. Thank you for the paper. True blue. The color is quite appropriate. I wanted to ask you, apparently for back issues, you're not going to have back issues available then?
No.
Then do you encourage people to make copies of this?
Absolutely, yes.
Get articles?
Oh, yes.
Okay, I'm looking at a document from Kinko's regarding copyrights. And Kinko's, for instance, a nationwide copy chain predominant in my area, will not touch a newspaper without some sort of a letter of permission. I wondered if it might be possible for you to print in the paper a letter of permission for copying of individual articles to avoid the problem of having to get a letter directly from y'all.
Great idea. We'll do that. The only thing that we require, if you're making copies and handing them out to your friends and neighbors, you don't need anything. We'll put some in the paper. If you're going to reprint it in another newspaper or a magazine or something like that, the only thing that we ask is you print the article in full. Don't take anything out of context, and give the proper credit due to whoever the writer was of the article. And our list of writers will grow as the paper grows. That's all that we ask. We want people to get this information. We want them to share it with others. We want it to be useful, because I think this is going to be one of the greatest tools to educate the American public that's ever been around, because you won't find rumor in this paper. You won't find anything that's not documented, that's not referenced to the source, that you can't go find yourself.
I'm just trying to figure out how to get a copy of an article without cutting up my own copy of the paper, and that's why I was thinking perhaps of taking it down to Kinko's, having them Xerox on their 36-inch wide Xerox a facsimile copy, then I could cut apart.
Yeah, well, you can do that, and in the next paper we'll put a little blurb saying that anybody has permission to copy any part of the newspaper, and we'll a little paragraph stating what I just said. And we'll make it retroactive to this issue so that you can take it down there and show it to them, and they'll let you copy it.
Very good. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you for calling, and thank you for bringing up a good point that we obviously forgot. And that's, you know, that's what you're out there for, to help us out. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yeah, my name's Victor McGee. I'm with the Constitution Party here in South Carolina.
Hi, Victor. How are you?
I'm doing just fine. I just got your paper today. Veritas?
Uh-huh.
It was excellent, excellent. And I like the open letter part of it. I like all the documentation. I like the advertising. I liked everything. I mean, I was a subscriber to Mr. Limbaugh's letter. I still am. And it's a whole lot better than his little magazine ever would be.
Wait a minute. Say that. Did you say that my newspaper, I should say our newspaper, is better than Rush Limbaugh's newspaper?
I got his chart. I was a charter member of Rush Limbaugh's paper. I've got one of his books, the first one.
Uh-huh.
And it's better because you've got the documentation. You don't have your slant. You don't have a slant to the truth of it. It's just like straight. I mean, what you've got over here with all the high treason and nothing is hidden, read it and weep, and you've got all the documentation. You got all the years. You go from like 1776 all the way up, and you show you've got a trail that you can follow through 200 years of this new world order being implemented, and we got the documentation. See, this is what we've been needing. You can't hardly get people to listen to a cassette tape or watch a video.
Mm-hmm.
You can run a copy of this and hand it to them, or they'll just read, you know, read the one that you have.
Yeah, one of the common things that I get is that, oh, no, there's no new world order. I mean, George Bush, you're just referring to, you know, the Soviet Union fell, and then, you know, it's a different world. That's not true, is it?
No, you gotta. I'm basically new to this. I mean, I'm surprised at, you know, at what I've learned in the last year. I mean, I've joined this Constitution Party, but about eight of us down here in South Carolina, and we're gonna have our first meeting, and we're gonna on April 1st.
Well, I think once I probably announce it on the air, you'll find that there'll be a lot more than eight.
Well, I hope so. I hope
that is, if you let me know when you're meeting.
So it's going to be on April 1st, and it's going to be at the Holiday Inn in Rock Hill, South Carolina, right on the interstate. I mean, I went and rented a meeting hall, and we're going to be there all day.
At what time?
At 11 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 3 o'clock, and 5 o'clock. I'll hold four meetings, and we got to get this thing off the ground, get this nation straightened back up.
So that's April 1st?
Huh?
April 1st, you said?
April the 1st.
And where at?
Rock Hill, South Carolina.
And where at?
On I-77.
But where on I-77?
On I-77 and US 21 in Rock Hill, South Carolina. There'll be an exit. The Holiday Inn will be right on your right. I made it where...
Holiday Inn, that's what I was looking for.
Okay, Holiday Inn. And one of their big meeting halls.
Okay, and you're having it 11 and 1 and 3 and
5.
5, okay.
Different meetings. I mean, they don't have an excuse not to show up. They couldn't make it one certain time. They got the whole day to show up.
Wonderful. Okay, all everybody out there in South Carolina, you heard that. Make sure that you're there, Constitution Party meeting, and fax me something or send me something before then.
I don't have a fax machine, but I'll have somebody fax you something. The same number, correct?
Okay, make sure all the information is there that I need so that I can announce this again as it gets close to time.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Okay, I love the newspaper.
Thank you.
Thank
Good
you.
Night. 602-337-2524 is the number. If you've received your copy of Veritas, we'd like to know what you think about it. If you have any criticism, we'd like to hear that too. We want to make it as good as we possibly can. Good evening. You're on the air.
Good evening, Bill. I was wondering if you had seen a copy of a book I found in my collection here, and I just thought it was interesting. It's called A Veritas Foundation Staff Study, The Great Deceit, Social Pseudosciences by Archibald B. Roosevelt and Zygmunt Dobbs.
Nope, never heard of it.
Oh, I guess I'm going to have to make a copy of it for you. It's a 370-page expose.
Great. Make me a copy and send it to us.
It's great.
Send me the bill, and I'll send you the money for whatever your expense is.
Really? Okay, that's wonderful. Well, I'll have to get a newspaper to see what it's like, but I just wondered if you had this, because it was from 1964, and these people were, you know, right on the money.
Nope, we don't have it. Please send it.
All right.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Good night. 602-337-2524. Let's try to keep it to Veritas, although I'm glad he called because I really would like to have that book. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hey, Bill. God bless. This is Dave from Oklahoma.
Hello.
I tell you what, everybody in the country is wearing out their speed dialing fingers tonight. love the paper. Excellent job. If you had to do away with the blue at the top, at the expense of putting in a couple more pages, it's nice. The blue is nice. But you could lose it if you wanted to print a few more pages. You just have to weigh that.
No, we would never sacrifice pages for blue. I mean, we'll do the blue as long as we can afford it, and we won't sacrifice anything for it.
It's a nice touch. I'm not a newspaper pro like you talked about before, but I've done a bit of publishing and done some newsletter stuff, and I know what you're up against getting something out like this. It's a ton of work.
Yes, it is.
It is a ton. A
lot more than we ever thought, I'll tell you that.
Just a couple of friendly criticisms. Proofreading, need some proofreading. One suggestion would be to find volunteer proofreaders. If there's nobody available in your area that could do it, perhaps people that you know around the country, you could download the sucker to them, have them read it, proofread it, send it back to you, and do that. There are a lot of proofreading errors.
There's a lady up in Utah who edited my book. Her name is Margaret Pinion.
Right.
I'd really like to get a hold of her. I'd like to make her the editor.
So
we're trying to do that.
Yeah, just from the little bit of publishing that I've done, I have found that the spell checker does not always quite cut it. And you do want to get everything exactly right. Otherwise, in the eyes of some people, it takes away from your credibility a little bit.
Well, we're not worried about that. Anybody who would say something's not credible because the spell checker didn't catch a word, in my estimation, isn't even worth bothering about, but we will certainly improve everything as we go along.
Right. Well, you're doing a good job. Documentation-wise, I was wondering if you had something planned similar perhaps to what, like, Perspectives Magazine does. As far as at the end of each article, they'll have some sites and references.
No, all of our sites are in the articles, and where they can't be in the article, they will be at the end.
That's cool. Yeah.
And the reason we do that is because I found that if the site is with what you say, then the person understands that information is can be checked. And they don't have to wait to get to the end of the article, and then they look at a bunch of sites and they don't know what it goes with.
Right.
And most people don't check footnotes anyway, although I found a lot of people, if you don't have footnotes, they'll say, well, this isn't documented and doesn't have footnotes. But you give them footnotes and they don't check the footnotes, they just automatically assume that you're right. So that's why we put it with the information in the article. And you'll see some articles where there will be sites at the end of the article where it's not appropriate to put them inside.
Right, right. As referenced, the two critiques that were done in the newspaper regarding the Soldier of Fortune articles, I was real glad to see that. I used to be a subscriber of Soldier of Fortune and then just decided not to renew for a couple of reasons. I remember around the first of the year they swagged Linda Thompson in one of their issues.
Well, you got to remember Beckwith and Greit came from the same place. Delta has significant meaning in the occult secret societies, and it's no accident that it's called Delta Force. Delta
right.
literally means penis. It means the generative force of a male organ. It is the same thing as looking at an obelisk.
Well, they got theirs spoken out, that's for sure.
Yeah.
In those militia articles, that was one thing that I was interested in as far as looking at the different documentation and stuff. I thought it was real neat. Because you had mentioned on the air, oh, I guess it was last week, regards the militia posting public notices.
Right.
As far as their formation and organization and when they were going to do things.
It's absolutely mandatory if you don't want to be branded a paramilitary terrorist organization. You have to be legal.
Well, that was a little bit of information I had not heard before, and it was neat to read about that in those articles, and being able to go back and look at some of the stuff and find out where that comes from, that's something that I personally am interested in, and everybody else I think should be also, to make sure that what they're doing is legal.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hey, good job, man.
Thank you.
See ya.
And thank you for your suggestions. We'll certainly take them into consideration. And copy reading, we know we got to do. We need an editor that's really a professional editor. And I'm amazed that these boys and me did what we did without one, to tell you the truth. I'm stymied. I'm stunned, to tell you the truth. Good evening. You're on the air.
Bruce?
Yes.
Oh, I need to find out how to order this paper. By money order.
Send your money order for $50 if you live in the United States for 24 issues.
Okay.
To Veritas, V-E-R-I-T-A-S.
V-E-R-I-T-A-S.
Yeah, make checks or money orders out to Veritas.
Okay, sir.
And send them to P.O. Box 3390.
3390.
St. John's, Arizona.
St. John's. Okay.
85936.
85936.
Right. If you're interested in becoming a distributor, or if you're interested in advertising in the newspaper, call Bart anytime, Wednesday through Sunday, between the hours of 9 a.m. and 6 p.m. at 602-337-2562. That's 602-337-2562.
All right, sir. If I get a money order in the mail in the morning, can I get a copy of this first issue?
I can't promise you that because they're almost all gone.
Oh, okay.
We only printed 2,000 copies of the first issue.
And
most of them went to subscribers. The rest of them went to, or most of the rest of them are scheduled, either have gone or are scheduled to go to people in Washington, D.C., or the state governors, and also people that we chose at random just to receive a free copy.
That'd be a good commemorative issue idea one day.
Oh, I guarantee you it'll be a collector's item.
Okay. Hey, I appreciate it, sir.
Because most of them will hit the trash can eventually, and there'll only be a few out of this 2,000 run that'll survive.
Well, I'll tell you, I just got started listening to these talk radio shows here 5 or 6 months ago, and I've been brain dead up to then.
Well, don't feel bad. I was brain dead for a good major portion of my life, too.
But by golly, it's eye-opening. And it's about time. I've got to where I'm banging head with city councilmen and state senators and anybody else who's got an address or a telephone number.
Yep.
So I think it's what it's going to take is let somebody know that all of us are not asleep out here. You know, one of us alone can't do it.
Yeah, that's true.
A bunch of us can.
I can assure you that one of us alone can't ever do it. I've been trying for years. It takes all of us together. That's why I'm so adamant at waking people up no matter what it takes. Thank you for calling.
I appreciate it.
602-337-2524 is the number. For those of you who never wrote it down, or those of you who may have never called or may just have begun to listen tonight. Good evening. You're on the air.
Good evening, Bill. How are you doing?
Fine.
Bravo on Veritas. Bravo. Very, very good.
Thank you.
Okay. I have a question here for you here. Did you ever read a publication called Secret and Suppressed by Jim Keith?
No.
No?
I've heard of it, but I've never seen it. I could never find it.
Oh, I see. Okay. Can I give you the place to get it?
Yeah, go ahead real quick. Well, I'll tell you what. Rather than waste these last few minutes, I'd rather you send it to me.
Very good.
Send it to me in the mail so that we can get some more callers in here.
All right, very good. Thank you. Bye-bye.
602-337-2524. I'd like to hear from people who have received their copy of Veritas. What do you like about it? What don't you like about it? What's your favorite article? Were you surprised? Were you, were you not surprised? Is this what you expected? So give us a call, 602-337-2524. And I'd like to hear specifically from people who have already received their copy of Veritas. Good evening, you're on the air.
Good evening. How you doing, Bill?
Fine.
We got our first copy of your paper today. My wife's enjoying it very much. It's a wonderful paper. I guess I'll get to see after I can pry it out of her hands.
Where are you from?
I'm from California.
What do you think about it?
Well, Well, I, like I said, I've got to pry it out of my wife's hand. She's a very, very, very good taper.
Where's she at?
She's laying in the living room listening to you on the satellite dish right now.
Put her on the phone. Let's hear what she has to say.
Well, let's see if I can get a hold of her.
Okay. Let me see if I can entice her to come to the phone.
Well, here she is right here. I'll put her on.
Wonderful.
Hi.
Hi.
I like your paper very much.
Really? What do you like most about it?
I like the way you have all these years and quotations right out of their stuff, where you can put it in front of somebody's face and say, see, I told you so.
Makes it easy, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
People can't run and call you crazy anymore, can they?
Well, they probably still will, but... you know, that's their problem.
Well, if they do, they'll be making a complete ass out of themselves when they're confronted with the proof and the quotes and the sources right in front of their face. That's pretty hard to argue with.
I think so. I think this is absolutely fantastic, and I was really excited to hear you say that we could photocopy off this and pass around.
Oh, yes, I hope that you do. I want you to.
Oh, good, because there's a few of us that pooled our money together to get this. We're planning on passing it around between us, then this will be really nice.
Wonderful. You know, you can also earn some extra money, too, by selling subscriptions. 10 subscriptions is $100 in your pocket.
Yeah, I got the letter from you telling about that. I just have to find some people with some money first.
Yeah.
But I don't think it would be all that hard to sell, especially if I let them take a peek at mine.
Wonderful.
But I like it very much.
Well, I thank you for coming to the phone to share that with us.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And
bye.
Thank you for calling.
Bye.
Well, folks, that just about does it. I think we can take one more call. If there's one more person out there that wants to get in a quick call, do it now. 602-337-2524. Good evening. You're on the air. You made it just under the gun.
Just barely. Well, I got my copy of Veritas today.
Uh-huh.
And I just wanted to tell you that I think it's excellent. And I really tend to believe what you say every time, but, you know, when I got it, I thought, this really is a newspaper, you know, because I knew you said it was going to be a real newspaper size, but
uh-huh.
It's a full-size newspaper, and it's, I'm astounded by the information you have there.
Wonderful.
I think you've got the information that, condensed form of what you had in the treason documents, is that true?
Yes. Yes, it is. We didn't go into the symbology and the religion of the mysteries, but we certainly hit the chronology and what they've been up to all those years.
Right. One thing I am disappointed in is that you say that you've only printed 2,000 copies, and I wonder if the finances and the problems of reprinting, but that's such good information that you have there I wonder if it wouldn't be good to have more copies of it. All these people across the country are going to be really wanting their own copy of
it. Well, maybe down the line we'll reassess that decision, but right now the decision amongst all of us is not to reprint. That doesn't mean that we can't change our mind at some future date, but right now it doesn't look like we're going to do that.
Well, you've done a fine job.
Well, thank you very much. I really appreciate that. Thank you for calling.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Well, folks, it's that time again. I want to thank you all for listening. I want to thank everybody who called in with their comments and those of you who gave us constructive criticism. And I even want to thank the little poopy diaper guy for strengthening our position by showing what a jerk socialists really are. They never can argue the facts. They can't even present a case. They're just lost in la-la land. Good night. I really love you, folks, and God bless each and every single one of you.
A long time coming, but I know a change. change gon' come. Oh, yes it will. It's been too hard to live it, but I'm afraid to die. I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I'm